Okay, I'll make a little video here. Got this 91 Carcano that I've had for, I don't know, I can't really actually remember where I got the thing, but the barrel is sort of, but I don't actually remember shooting it, so, you know, bad barrels can actually shoot good, sort of, sometimes, so, anyway, I figured I'd put it back together, because I had taken it apart, and I had, like, the mag and the trigger, I put on my Cooey Carcano, because it had those set triggers, and one of them was busted off, and so I just put that on it, and I shot it years ago, and it seems to work, but I'm going to put this thing back together. I think I got all the parts here. I got the nose cap, and barrel band, and two action screws, hand guard. This thing was sort of, I don't know, refinished by somebody one time. It's sort of, you see where they ground. I don't know if you can see it or not, but there's like grind marks on it. And they put, I don't know if it was a cold blue or something they put on it. But in this front screw here, I don't know if it was, this is the one that was in the junk with it, but it's not quite long enough. Like, it would work if the threads weren't all messed up, because when you thread it in this way, it grabs, but it's a tiny bit short, so it's probably for one of the other ones. Because it sits on the surface on this one, on 91. And the other ones, they go, like on a 41 rifle, they go down in a hole, and I think some of the carbines are like that too. But anyway, looks like just put a piece of coat hanger through it and bend it over. That would hold it for now, but I'll have to find another screw, I guess. So let me get the bolt, straight bolt handle. But yeah, they sort of sanded the stock a little bit and stuff, but it's not quite, you know, it's not horrendous, because the wood is still bigger than the butt plate here. And the wood's a metal. The metal is a tiny bit proud there, but which is pretty grubby inside. An interesting repair right there. I don't know if I had a cleaning rod for this or not. I can't remember. I had one. I think one came with my other one, but it, I think there's a bunch of junk down in the stock here, and it, I don't know, they screw into the end of the nose cap, but it goes down, but it won't thread into anything. I don't know if they actually supposed to thread in down inside. I don't see anything that they would screw into. Usually it was like a block of metal or something if they thread it in down here too, but I don't think there's anything like part of the recoil thing there. I don't believe so, but I'm not totally sure. But anyway, just giving the thing a try anyway. I still have some of the bigger Hornady bullets. It'd be nice if it actually would shoot 264 bullets, but I'm not, probably wouldn't happen anyway. Drag it around the woods a little bit. Ask everything else. This sight is a bit weird, like this button, you can pull this off almost. So I don't know how they're supposed to be. I think they're just put on and they hit them or something. I'm not sure. Little metal thing with the, I don't know if that's Bakelite or what, that little plastic thing that's there. But you can pull this one almost. You can, well, yeah, see. You can pull it right off, so. be careful with that. I don't want to lose that. But she's a Tourney 1916, it was made. So that makes her, what, 104? But barrel looks quite dark in the grooves, but the muzzle looks like really terrible. It doesn't look terrible other than that. It's probably got some erosion. Like they get the gain twist anyway, so the rifling is fairly straight going, but then it looks quite worn. Like the rifling looked nice and smooth on the top, but over here they're kind of yucky looking. And then right at the end, it's hard to, like, looking at, you know, on this way, it's kind of hard to tell if it actually has rifling at all, but it's, so the muzzle does look kind of boogered up, but anyway. But you never know. I like to have that Chinese Mauser, and it looked like hell. So. Should put some linseed oil on that stock, because I don't know if they... doesn't look finished or anything. But actually, while we're looking at this barrel, probably a good time to talk about, like, 91-24s. Because they're supposedly just cut down 91 rifles, which I'm not totally buying, because I think if you just cut the barrel off with the gain twist, you're not going to get the accuracy at all. And some will actually shoot okay-ish. I think the ones that don't, I think it's more a product of they're just, like, old, shot out, like, because a lot of them you'll find they're, like, conversions of really old guns, which they probably picked the ones that were, you'd think they would pick decent ones to convert. You think wouldn't think they would convert shot out stuff. But they're all done, you know, before 1928. So they're not like terrible new or anything. But they're see, the barrel on this is about, what was it, 30.5, I guess. In the 91-24 they're like what, 17.7 or something. So there's more than enough. My theory always was that it seemed like they would, maybe they cut the end of the barrel off and cut it off here. Like, you look at 91-24, like, I've never seen one. I don't own one. I don't know if there's actually any in Canada. I don't know. But you come out just ahead of the back sight here, and then it steps down, like, drastically. It's like, I was kind of thinking that they cut it off here, then they drilled this out and threaded it, and then screwed the end of the barrel back into this. Because there's more than enough barrel here. Like, if you go from about here out to the end, you got like 24.5 inches of barrel left. You could shove it back in. I don't know how far they would come if they go all the way. Like, if this is fat enough that they could drill it out and thread the whole thing, and it would obliterate the chamber, and then you redo the chamber too. But I'm not totally sure. But see, it only goes to be, you know, 17 and like 3/4 or so. It'd be like there. If you went from all the way back forward, but you still got more than enough barrel, you could either, you know, if you went to the front of the chamber, and then, I'm not sure how they would do that if they did do it that way. Like, it'd be kind of nice if somebody would look at one and see, is there anything where it looks like they drilled it through and threaded it, kind of like the Cooey Carcano, because you can see where the barrel is threaded into the, because they left this much on the Cooey Carcano. It's like just this, where am I? Just this part, because the backside is the remnants of this. So it's that much. They drilled that out and threaded that and then screwed the new barrel into it. So you know, if they cut it off here. And I was wondering, maybe that's why it dips down so much, but maybe they just turn them down that much. I don't know, maybe they just cut them off out here, turn that all down, then put the front sight back on. But then you would get the slow twist. So if you cut the end of the barrel off and shoved it back into itself, you'd have the faster twist part of the barrel, which would make sense. Like, I don't think they were that dumb, were they? I don't know. Like, there's never been a government program that was a big fiasco or anything. Like, that never, you know, if it was done in Canada, it might have come out that way. But anyway, we kind of, somebody, I suppose if somebody had like a 9124 that was totally rotten and totally trash, like, take the barrel off and mill the side of the barrel off, and you could see if there was, you know, looks like it was put back together or drilled out, or sleeved the barrels, or they cut them off and screwed them back into themselves, or, it'd be kind of cool to know that, because it's been going around for years that it was, oh, they're just cut off, like they just went out to, and from here to, you know, 18 inches or around here, and just lopped her off there, and then turned her down, and then stuck that front sight back on. That's the story. Going around for years. I think I've said it in the past, but it's just, when you start thinking about it more and more, it just doesn't make a lot of sense. Like, it's quite possible they would do it that way, but it just seems stupid that you would take a perfectly good rifle and convert it into something that was inaccurate. Like, oh, it's like, oh, it's way more easy and handy to run around with, but it's, you can't hit nothing with it, so what's the point? Like, that's just, I think I'd rather have the big, long, stupid rifle that actually was still accurate, you know? Like, anyway, that's just me. So, anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and we will talk to you later.